the PTA, which tells you what's probably going on. Probably have primary hyperparathyroidism. What if my calcium is high and my PTA is below normal? Something else doing that calcium problem? The most common cause of hypercalcemia in domestic animals is malignancy. It's called the hypercalcemia of malignancy. And that is a PTH-like hormone in some instances. It will not cross-react on our PTH assay. So if my PTH is low and I have hypercalcemia, those two don't go together, do they? And so you basically want to look at your PTH-like hormone. If it's high, it's a neoplastic process. Okay, and we'll get some cases for that. What about decreased PTH? What if my calcium levels are very low and my PTH is very low? Does that go together? What's that tell you? Why are my calcium levels low? My PTH is low. Could that be a primary hyperparathyroidism? Hypoparathyroidism. Sorry about that. Primary hyperparathyroidism. And remember, is the parathyroid controlled by the pituitary or the hypothalamus? No, what controls it is blood calcium levels. Okay? So if the calcium level is normal, my PTH should be in normal range, right? If my calcium levels are low and my PTH is high, then it tells me something's causing the hypocalcemia that my parathyroid is trying to make up for, right? If my PTH is high and my calcium is high, primary hyperparathyroidism. If my PTH is low and my calcium is low, primary hypoparathyroidism. Does that make sense? And that's how you interpret it. Okay, well, we're going to call it quits there. I'm going to have to go negotiate with Dr. Wurtu to see if I can get a few more class lectures from him so we can finish this stuff up. I always get behind. Oftentimes, now, if we get to the pancreas and stuff, we will do that in ClinPath next semester. Okay? We'll try. I'll see if I can negotiate a few more hours out of it. Now, what I've done is...